Hello friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video in which we are going to discuss many questions and the most important two reports of the day. So let's begin this video, but before that, if you are a newcomer here, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we provide you with free quizzes as well as we try to resolve your queries directly. So if you want to directly connect with us, then you can just join this group from the link given in the description below. This is the new course for 2022 of RBI Grade B, in which you will get PDFs, videos and mocks. Apart from this, you will get mock interviews as well. So these mock interviews will prepare you for your interviews in RBI. Here you will have a booklet as well at your doorstep, and that booklet will contain all the books mentioned here in this slide. Right now we are running a 30% discount on this course, and you can avail that discount by using the RBI 30 coupon code. And this is the number where you can just call us, or if you have any queries related to the examination or syllabus eligibility, anything where you require help, you can just call us on this number. Now let's begin the video with this first question. Okay. Which country hosted the Summit on Financing African Economies 2021? So France, Russia, Poland, Nigeria and Ethiopia are in the options. Out of these options, the right answer is option A, France. So French President Emmanuel Macron has hosted this Summit on Financing African Economies, in which various issues related to the African economies were discussed. Now the synosure of the eye here is that from India, the Minister of State for External Affairs, B. Muralidharan, attended this Summit on Financing African Economies 2021, and he elaborated how India is helping African countries in terms of various projects, in terms of financing the various infrastructure projects in different African countries. Apart from this, he also mentioned that India had supplied many doses, approximately 24.7 million vaccine doses to different countries of Africa. So these were some measures through which India is helping out African countries, and these measures were highlighted by Minister of State for External Affairs Ministry, V. Muralidharan, who attended this summit. Now guys, here the question that can be framed out of this news is that who is the present state Minister of State of Ministry of External Affairs? Then your answer would be V. Muralidharan. So here you have to pay focus on the personalities that are in news. Okay, so that was all about this question. There was nothing much that we can discuss. So here comes our second question, and this is one of the two most important reports that I mentioned in the beginning of this video. So do listen to me very carefully in this report. What is India's rank in the Renewable Energy Country Attractiveness Index 2021? So we have five numbers. Out of these five numbers, the right ranking is 3. So India is the third top ranking country in this Renewable Energy Country Attractiveness Index. Now, which organization has released this index? So it is released by EY, that is Ernst & Young. So this company or this organization remains in the news because of its various kinds of reports that it releases on India, and this report is one such kind. But I would like to say that this report is important for you to remember, because I believe that this report has potential to become a question in your upcoming examination. Now let me tell you a fact related to EY. So this EY is basically headquartered in London, so it is a London based company. Okay, so that was about EY. Now let us look at this index, what this index has in store for us. So the first point here is that it is the 57th edition of this Renewable Energy Country Attractiveness Index. Remember that this index is published biannually. Now the total number of countries that were assessed was 40, and USA has topped in it. India is at the third rank, and India's score is 66.2. Here you have to remember India's score also. This point is important because it is stating the solar installed capacity of India, that is 39 gigawatts. Again, if you remember some days back, I had also talked about solar capacity and how the solar capacity additions are important. Next is bottom, which country has ranked at the bottom? It is Kenya. The next point here is very important for us, that is in 2020, global renewable energy capacity investments grew by 2%. To $303.5 billion. Now this is an amazing achievement for the entire globe in the year 2020, which was the dark year, I would say, because the entire world was engulfed under this pandemic. the coronavirus pandemic, but still the investments in the renewable energy capacity grew by 2% and it stood at $303.5 billion, which is the second highest annual growth. So this is amazing, right? The next point here is important. Renewable energy sector requires $5.2 trillion investment in future to achieve the net zero emissions. So this is the requirement in investments if we were to use the renewable energy source to achieve the net zero emissions. So we need $5.2 trillion investment in the renewable energy in the entire globe. Of course, we are not talking about India only. Okay, so these were the major facts highlighted by this report. Now, this is a picture directly taken from the report. This picture highlights the ranking of top 10 countries in this index and the scores as well. And here the technology scores based on different solar and different renewable energies. Like we have solar photovoltaic, solar CSP, biomass, geothermal, hydro. So these are the different sources of renewable energy. And on the basis of these renewable energy resources, each and every country have been given these scores. Now you don't have to remember all the scores given to all the countries. Just pay attention to the highlighted one. That is India's scores in each and every resource, in each and every technology, as well as India's overall score. That is 66.2. So I hope that this report is clear to you. If you have any problems regarding that report, then you can just ask me in the comment section below. Moving on to the third question, this is the second report of the two reports that I talked about in the beginning. So this is again an important report. Listen to me very carefully. How many people were displaced in 2020 as per the 2021 global report on internal displacement in changing climate report? So let me tell you that the name of this report is Global Report on Internal Displacement. Great. But the highlight of this year's report was the changing climate. So climate change was the focus of this year's report. So therefore this is the subtitle of this report. Okay, now coming back to the question, how many people were displaced in 2020? So 30 million, 23 million, 40, 55, 60 million. So to be precise, the right answer is option D. At the end of December 2020, there were a total of 55 million people that stood internally displaced in the world. And let me tell you guys that this is the highest record that has been achieved in terms of internal displacement. And that displacement is caused by disasters and the conflict and violence. So these were the two major reasons, conflict and violence and the natural disasters that caused internal displacement. So natural disasters plus conflict and violence were the two main reasons that caused internal displacement. Now this report has mentioned a lot of facts that are important from your exam point of view, both for phase 1 as well as for phase 2 of ESI. So you have to listen from the perspective of both the phases. Okay. So the first slide tells us that this report is released by Internal Displacement Monitoring Center in collaboration with Norwegian Refuge Council. So these two organizations have collaborated to launch this report. Now the second fact is about the question itself. The fact that we discussed in the question itself. The total number of people living in internal displacement reached a record 55 million by the end of 2020. So the total number of people living in internal displacement was 55 million. Guys, here there is a distinction. I'm not saying that 55 million people were internally displaced in 2020, because that is not the truth. The truth is that at the end of 2020, the total number of people who were living in internal displacement was 55 million. Now, there is a difference between these two statements. First statement highlights that the new displacements were 55 million, whereas the second statement is highlighting that the new displacements are not 55 million, but the total number of people who are living in internal displacement, that might include the new displacement as well as the older existing internally displaced people, reached 55 million. So that is the difference between these two statements. And here I'm saying that the total number of people living in internal displacement reached 55 million, not new displacements. Okay, so this is the fact that you should keep in your mind clear. Okay, so out of these 55 million people, 48 million people were displaced due to conflict and violence. whereas 7 million people were displaced due to natural calamities, natural disasters. Now, this 48 million people consist of, or we can say, are majorly concentrated in the Middle East countries where the terrorist attacks and violence conflict are very rampant. The next point here is, in 2020, 40.5 million new displacements were triggered across the world by disasters and violence, the highest annual figure recorded in a decade. So I hope that now you can understand the difference between the 55 million and 40.5 million. Okay, so 40.5 million were the new displacements that were added in the year 2020. Moving on to the next slide, which is focusing on the Asian region, particularly on the South Asian region. So Cyclone Amphan alone triggered 5 million displacements across Bangladesh, Bhutan, India and Myanmar. So this is very clear. China has the highest number of internally displaced people in 2020 at 5 million, followed by Philippines and Bangladesh. So these are pure facts, guys. There is nothing that we can understand. So I'm just reading out the facts for you. But in case if you have any problem in understanding each and everything, then you can just mention it in the comment section. The number of people living in internal displacement worldwide has reached a record high as of 31st December 2020, when there were more than twice as many internally displaced people than refugees. So this is how the internal displacement is increasing. And the most shocking fact here is that 58% of that internal displacement is caused by the violence and conflict. So that is the shocking fact, that is the tragic fact here, we can say. Okay, moving on to India related facts. So 3.9 million new disaster displacements were in India in 2020, because Amphan, Nicaragua and many cyclones were there in the year 2020. So this Amphan cyclone hit Indian eastern coast. Basically, West Bengal and Odisha were the two states that were affected the most due to this Amphan, and it caused 2.4 million evacuations in the year 2020. Then we have Cyclone Nisarga that prompted 170,000 evacuations in Maharashtra and Gujarat just 2 weeks later after this Amphan hit West Bengal and Odisha. So these were the facts related to India. Okay, so this is our next question. Which is the top-ranked Indian city in the Prime Global Cities Index Q1 2021 report of Knight Frank? So this Knight Frank is basically a real estate evaluation company that is located in London. Now, this Prime Global Cities Index is basically focusing on the prime cities prices, residential prices in the first quarter of 2021. So remember that it is focusing on the first quarter of 2021, and this report primarily focuses on the residential prices, the movement of the residential prices, and on the basis of that it ranks more than 45 cities. So the scope of this ranking is not very broad. It is restricted to just 45 cities, more than 45 cities, but not a very large number of cities are covered by this index. Now, which city from India is the highest ranked? So it is Delhi. Delhi is ranked at 32nd position, and Delhi is the highest ranked city in this index. Now, apart from Delhi, you have Mumbai and Bangalore. So Mumbai is at 36. Apart from Mumbai, the third highest ranked Indian city is Bangalore, and its ranking is 40. Now, which city has topped this entire ranking, this overall ranking? It is topped by Shenzhen. Shenzhen is a city in China. So that has topped this index. Now, guys, I think we have discussed many facts related to this report, which can be of use for your upcoming examination. Okay, so our next question is, when is the World Bee Day observed? So we have 5 dates right in front of us, and out of these dates, the right answer is option B. May 20 is the date on which World Bee Day is observed. Now, what is the theme for 2021? So the theme for 2021 is Bees Engaged, Build Back Better for Bees. So let me write it down for you guys. So this is the theme, Bees Engaged, Build Back Better for Bees. Now, guys, related to this World Bee Day, let me tell you that on the occasion of this World Bee Day, Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar announced to set up a honey testing laboratory in Indian Agricultural Research Institution, which is in Pusa, Delhi. So that was the first fact related to this new, this World Bee Day. I hope that you can remember it well, that honey testing laboratory is going to be established at Indian Agricultural Research Institute, that is located in Pusa in New Delhi. Apart from this, you should also know that in India, we have National Bee and Honey Mission in place. So guys, do you know when was this National Bee and Honey Mission launched initially? So National Bee and Honey Mission was launched in 2018 for 2 years, 2018 to 2019 and 2019 to 2020. So this National Bee and Honey Mission was launched for 2 years, and the purpose is clearly to prompt the sweet revolution, to increase the sweet revolution. So this National Bee and Honey Mission was launched for 2 years, 2018 to 2019 to 2020, and the purpose is clearly to promote the beekeeping in India. Now, in the year 2021, in February 2021 only, rupees 500 crores were allocated by the central government for this mission for 3 years, starting from 2020 to 2021 to 2022 to 2023. So clearly we can see that this mission has been extended by 3 years till the year 2023, and remember that this allocation was made as part of the Atmanirbhar package. Now clearly we can see that this National Bee and Honey Mission has been linked to the Atmanirbhar package to achieve Atmanirbharta in the beekeeping segment, in the field of beekeeping. Atmanirbharta refers to self-dependence, so that we can become self-dependent in honey production and can increase the income of farmers associated with the beekeeping as well as honey mission, honey production. Now guys, you should also know this fact that United Nations has designated the year 2021 as the International Year of Fruits and Vegetables. So this is again an important and current news. You should know this thing, that this year is the International Year of Fruits and Vegetables. Now we have discussed, I guess, many facts related to this World Bee Day. I would like to ask a question from you, and that question is that you have to tell me the chairperson of Beekeeping Development Committee. This is your task. I think it is a little bit difficult question, but I hope that my students are brilliant enough to give me the right answers. Even though if you can't find the answer, then just mention it in the comment section below. I'm going to tell you the answer about the chairperson of Beekeeping Development Committee. So don't worry, don't hesitate. You can just mention your answers in the comment section below. And as far as this World Bee Day is concerned, I hope that all the facts are clear to you. In case you have any doubt related to this question or any question that I have taught so far, you can just mention it in the comment section, or you can just ping me on the Telegram group. Now guys, that was all for this question, but before leaving this slide, I would like to tell you guys that do pay attention to this National Bee and Honey Mission. Do cover all the provisions related to this mission, because this is again in the news. It can be asked from you in your examination. Okay, so this is the last question. Which country has developed Simru supercomputer? So it is developed by Iran. Now guys, it is the fastest supercomputer of Iran. So remember, it is the fastest supercomputer of Iran till date that Iran has developed. So this is Simru, developed by Iran's indigenous university. And there is nothing much that you can remember from this question. My question from you is that you have to tell me that which country has the world's fastest supercomputer. This is your question that you have to mention in the comment section below. And if you are following the current affairs regularly, then you would definitely know the answer of this question. Tell me the fastest supercomputer of the world. And on that note, let's say goodbye to each other. I hope that you have enjoyed and learned something from this video. And if you have, then don't forget to subscribe and like this video. Thank you so much for watching the video.